This is CNEagles.com and the Vickee Kazee-Hollifield Show. I'm the voice of the Eagles, Adam Cavalier. Vickee's out for the day, so we bring in Carson-Newman senior catcher Bree Shoemake. Bree, thanks so much for stopping by. First time that we've had you on the program.
Thank you.
Not a bad senior season for you, batting better than 360 on the year as the Eagles set at 20-10 with roughly 16 games left. How has this year gone for you and from your perspective as a four-year player for Coach Kazee-Hollifield?
Overall, it's been really well. Actually, this team, we've come together as a team really well, and we've brought out the bats for sure, and I just think everybody's getting along and just putting together what we can do as Carson-Newman softball, and it's just worked out really well.
A big two-game set tomorrow against Lenoir Rhine, league leaders. They're 9-1 over their last 10 games. Carson-Newman LR seems to be the big softball rivalry. What does playing the Bears force you to bring out in yourself?
Just as a whole, we just have to work on flawless defense, and we have to keep the bats going and pitching as well. Just everything has to work. You know, if you win two categories out of the three, you're going to be victorious of the day. So we just have to come out and play Carson-Newman softball as a whole, and we will be fine.
Talk about getting the defense right. What steps have you – you're right, the bats have been just stupid good all season long, but what do you have to do to get pitching and defense where they need to be as well?
We just have to just focus in, you know, don't think about making an error. Just go out there and just field it and do what you know. We know we practice long and hard, and we work out all the errors and make sure that we don't make those in games. So we just have to, you know, focus in and just play hard.
Is it a matter of not thinking too – and just reacting to the situation on the field?
Kind of. You know, you just have to put everything else aside and just go out there and just don't think. Like, I guess that would be a good term to use, is just don't think. Just go out there and just play ball for 14 innings and just be carefree and just don't think you're going to make an error. Just go out there and just play how you know how to play, and you'll be fine.
16 games left before you hit the SAC tournament, hopefully as long as you can maintain the current lead. What do you have to do between now and then to you talk about getting better defensively, but really crest at the right time headed into the tournament?
We just have to keep working. Just don't settle for where we're at. I mean, we're 20-10, and we know that we're a lot better than that, and we just have to keep striving to become better and just don't settle and just work, because the teams are only going to get harder. They're not going to get any easier. So just working hard to achieve something that we all want to get to.
Some individuals achieving things this year for Carson-Newman and Brittany Hefner, the one that truly stands out. How can you not, with 65 RBI, right, seven away from school and SAC record, and a grand slam away from matching an NCAA record for the most in the year, and people are still pitching to her because players like yourself and Sara, Kelley, who we'll talk to in a little bit, are being productive offensively. What's that mean, that you're setting the stage for another teammate to have pretty ridiculous success this year?
I mean, it's great having Brittany behind me and Sara. It's just, I mean, it's awesome, actually. I know if I get on, you know, she's going to hit me in. And if I don't get on, if the one and two batters get on, she's going to work hard to do her job to get them around. And it's just great having that teammate behind you, knowing, you know, if you don't get it done, she's going to step up, or the person behind her is going to step up and do it. So you don't, the pressure's not always on you. It's great having teammates that can step up and do great things.
You can put a batting order together with Lady Eagles, and everybody's batting 300. Mm-hmm. Have you ever been in a situation like that in your career ever?
I don't think I have. It's possible that we might have been, but this year, out of all my 4 years, this has been the best hitting team that has been at Carson-Newman since I've been here, and it's a great feeling.
Why is that?
I just think, you know, people, we all strive to get on and we all want to do well, but, you know, if one of our teammates gets on, we're working hard to get them around or move them to home plate, just because we know they worked hard, so you want to work hard for your teammates.
Bree, pleasure as always. Thanks
Thank
for stopping
you.
By.
Thank you.
Carson-Newman catcher Bree Shoemake. We'll take a look at some of the images from the past week of Carson-Newman softball, and after that, we'll chat with Sara Kelley. That's after this.
Superstitious.
back on the Vickee Kazee-Hollifield Show. I'm the voice of the Eagles, Adam Cavalier, alongside Carson-Newman, third baseman Sara Kelley. Sara, pleasure as always. Thanks for coming on. Subbing in for Vic for a bit.
Thank you.
Not a bad year for you at the dish and in the field. How has 2013 gone for you personally as a player?
Personally, I just have a lot of good teammates behind me. I mean, obviously, defense is always, you always just strive to be better. And as a team, we can always strive to be better. We're not perfect, but we strive for that. So as the year goes, I'm just so thankful for the teammates that I have behind me at the plate and defensively.
This Carson-Newman lineup has been sort of absurd at times this year. We talked about it with Bree a bit before we went through the photo galleries for the past week. But everybody in the order can hit 300, and you and Bree are the bread to Brittany Hefner's meat in a 3-4-5 sandwich. What are you doing at the plate to set the stage for her, and what does she do for you to set the stage for you for arguably one of the more potent heart of the orders in the sack?
Right. We just try to get on base. That's our goal, get on base, because we know, like we always say, we're so glad she's on our team, because we wouldn't want to pitch to her if she was on someone else's. But she just, you know, she's incredible. And as a team, we just need to get on base because she will produce runs, and that's what's most important for us.
You look at Friday, big matchup with Lenore Ryan, 3 o'clock first pitch against the league-leading Bears. What does that matchup mean to you and to Carson Newman?
You know, we were picked fourth in the preseason picks, and that's big for us. You know, we always said, you know, they might keep us low to begin with, but we'll rise to the top, and it'll be a good matchup for us. They're a good team, and it'll be interesting to put our bats lined up together and see who comes out on top.
You get to spend spring break for the most part on the road. Obviously, now you're back in Jeff City, but you go Wingate to Augusta State. What does a trip like that do for you guys as a team to spend some time just with teammates and coaches for 5 days or so?
It is so great for team chemistry. We get to know each other a little better. I mean, obviously, we're together all the time anyways, but being away and just seeing how people act around each other and just coming together, it was just good team chemistry. Like, being on the beach and, you know, practicing on the beach was so much fun. It was just a really good experience for all of us.
It's a youth-heavy team, too. So how much does that help, given that, really, I mean, Bree and Cassie, Cassie Elliott are the only seniors, and then just you and a handful of other juniors on the squad.
You know, we played a lot at home in the beginning of the season, and the freshmen, that was good for them. But now that we're traveling a lot, they're starting to realize, hey, you know, this is what it really is. This is what college is. And being away and traveling, it kind of broke them in. Like, you know, this is time to buckle down and work really hard because this is what it's truly like. And Cassie and Bree do a really good job being leaders and, you know, leading the freshmen through it all.
Teach them the Lady Eagle way in some respects, too?
Yeah, like, just, you got to just work hard. Like, you know, you're going to come through adversity and things are going to get hard for you because freshman year is a tough struggle. But, you know, it just teaches you that it's what it's about, traveling and working hard. And the Eagle way is perfection, and that's what we got to strive for.
16 games left before you hope to make the SAC tournament. You can't lock in a bid just yet with that many games left, but how do you use that mindset over that over the home stretch to strive for perfection and go in red hot?
You know, we got to work hard. Our defense has got to come a long way. We've struggled a little bit more than so in my past, and being young out there, it's tough, but we can do it. I mean, we just have to work hard, and we do. Our freshmen work extremely hard, pitchers included, on the mound. You know, it's hard to have young ones out there, you know, setting the momentum of the game, but they do a great job, and we're just going to have to keep working behind them. That's what it's about.
What are you doing in practice to develop pitching and defense, which has been a rough spot at times this year?
Right. Defensively, we just take reps. Our arms are where they need to be in the infield. It's just, you just got to keep continuing to do fundamentals. That's what Coach Kazee has always been about. It's all about defensive fundamentals, and that's what we got to strive for. And, I mean, in the infield, we're pretty experienced in most areas. We just got to get our outfield rolling, and they'll get there. They're doing just fine. They just got to work on hitting their cuts.
Sara, pleasure as always. Thanks for stopping by.
Thank you.
Carson-Newman third baseman Sara Kelley. I'm the voice of the Eagles, Adam Cavalier. This has been the Vickee Kazee-Hollifield Show, and this is seeingeagles.com.